Hey guys, we are back with another video, and we are here. I'm just doing a random video, I don't know why, but I wanted to show you something that I have outside, which is probably the point of this video. So let me come and show. Oh, hold up, sorry guys. So as you guys can see, never mind, I don't think you could see it, but let me put it back to regular. I just wanted to try and show you, but mostly today, I'm gonna go watch the Cubs game, and I will see you at the Cubs game. Wait, let me just turn on the TV. Hold up, guys.
My solo is going really well, my turns are looking great, and I feel like my style's improved a lot from before I was injured.
He reminds me of that Springer or Riznik, that kind of guy.
Hold up, guys. This is not the baseball game. It is one, but it's different. Here we go. Here we go, it's the Cubs game. This is weird. Oh, they just started.
It's a three-pitch mix for Garcia, fastball, change, and slider.
Wait, you guys aren't even seeing it. Hold up. How do you...
6'3", 220. 25 years old. Sitting in a favorable count.
How do you show? What the?
Sharply hit roller right at Prado. Across the infield for out number two.
Man.
I think this speaks to where we are.
But hey guys, we gotta watch some Cubs.
Adam Conley, 2016, Wei-Yin Chin last year, and Garcia earlier this year. It's become almost common to have guys reach their pitch count in the sixth or seventh, and they get pulled at having allowed no hits. That never happened in previous decades. Well, deep center, but it'll be caught. Gather your thoughts, I'll let you comment.
They're killing the no-no. They're going to kill the no-no.
Oh.
Chris Bryant making sure there's no no-hitter tonight. And the Cubs lead 2-0 after an inning.
Five-hour energy.
There is a commercial.
It can even get you to the 2018 MLB All-Star Game. Buy any 5-hour energy products, including Cherry Extra Strength. Snap a picture of your receipt and send it in.
And there's a commercial. Oh my gosh, this thing is too charged.
Introducing Taco Bell's latest work of art. $1 triple melt nachos, seasoned beef with a lavish blend of three melted cheeses. Another $1 masterpiece, only at Taco Bell. Taco Bell.
There, you guys get to watch the game in peace.
It's in the air, on the breeze, in the hush, in the roar.
I don't think you want to see commercials now, but I'm walking, JQ, JKO,
boom. I'm here at Wrigley Field with this Miller Lite game report. Chris Bryant with his fifth home run of the year, a two-run shot to put the Cubs in front here early. And back in the good old days of Little League, that would have earned Chris Bryant $20 from his grandparents, and the story goes he was playing with 10-year-olds and his dad coaching the team said, hey, whoever goes deep, I'll give you $100. And Chris said, of course, it was one of his teammates that went deep, and he started bawling, crying his eyes out. 2 weeks later, he goes deep, dad gives him $100, and the grandparents, his grandparents, say, well, if that's all it takes, Chris, we'll pay you $20 every time you hit a home run. And that's where it all started, guys. But he did get $100 if he got a straight A report card. So certainly academics, very important in the Bryant household as well. But it's paying off these days, right?
Well, what I take out of that, thank you, Kelly, is Justin Bohr takes low, is that he was a terrible negotiator. He got $100 for a home run, and then it became 20. Well, he made a lot of money tonight. As a big leaguer, so he's doing
a good thing that story didn't come to light back then. He would have lost his amateur status. It's good to negotiate that incentive clause early in your career.
Here's a 2-1 Bohr, swings and misses on a changeup from Kyle. That home run, the first in the last 14 hit by the Cubs, with a man on base, and 13 consecutive solos. Deep to right, and caught by Zobrist, who's had a busy start to this one.
A screamer off the bat of Justin Bohr. He's a strong man. He really hit that ball sharply. Zobrist was well positioned, very deep to begin with. Got a nice break on this one.
So the Marlins, I think, are winning the exit velocity battle here early on, but they don't have a hit. It's Ryan Anderson. We saw him play third base in the opening series of the season with Prado on the DL. He's in right this evening. He had a real good series that weekend. 6-for-18, plus 3 walks, and knocked in 5 runs. It's all Major League rookies with 31 hits. Line in a 1-1, swing and a miss on a change.
Well, cut change, gets the swing and miss. Aspect of Kyle's game that's a little unsettling is the home runs allowed. He's allowed 8 long balls already this year. I suspect that'll start to normalize a little bit too. He allowed 17 all of last year. Just made a few mistakes up in the zone. It has cost him, but been aggressive. Now walking people, doing what he normally does. Came into this one with a 3.19 earned run average.
Strike on Derek Dietrich in left field, batting 6th.
The Marlins bottomed out at 5-17. And there's available a lot of it. Again, it's mostly been their pitching, but the last couple days, offensively in Cincinnati.
Berrettini adjustment to get back to the bag. So Kyle Hendricks getting some quick outs. Cubs back in the dugout leading 2-0.
Hey, want the fastest internet? Done. Now Xfinity Mobile is included. You can get up to 5 lines. Switching from AT&T saves over $500 your first year, which you could spend on a bug-tastic music video.
Simple, easy, awesome. Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months.
It's another commercial. It's another commercial, but a new rule. When there is commercials, I will pop in and give you some entertainment. Huh? What? Hold up, guys.
Happy birthday.
This is so exciting.
I wrapped it myself.